Hi everyone, so 2 weeks of my decluttering of clothes gets over and I am here to share with you my experience and also some things that will help us to declutter in a more systematic way. So the first one is to have a plan. Yeah, so you might think why having a plan in a decluttering process helps. It helps because it keeps you sane, because if you bring out everything, or if you're just looking through everything and just trying to pick things up one by one and saying, okay, this has to go, this has to go, it doesn't really work. So the plan would be to categorize each item. So for me, I started with clothes and my next step is books. So for me, when I look into books, I have 3 cartons full of books. And I need to plan on how I'm going to keep these books, because when it's in the carton, I'm not really using it. So if I plan to use it, or if I would want to keep it, I need to think about a storage space. So I need to look at the financials. So all this planning will definitely go into the decluttering process. So while you are in the journey, you also need to look into all these aspects of how you're going to organize the things that you want to keep. Are you just going to pack it away, or are you going to keep it in a space where you're going to regularly use these items that you have with you? You need to also look into the time factor, because you need to plan how much time am I going to take for this entire decluttering process. Of course, decluttering is something that will happen your entire lifetime, but right now if I'm planning to speed clean my place, or planning to just discard a lot of things that are not required, or if this is the first time that I am going to declutter my space, then definitely it needs to be time bound, otherwise it will take forever. So having a plan will definitely help you to be on the right track. The second one is, if it is organized, keep it organized. So what I mean is that when I get all my clothes, what I did is I knew that there were clothes that I was currently using. So I kept them back as it is folded. I did not bring everything out to see which one I'm using, which am I not using, and then again creating a lot of stress looking at all the clothes that are lying around. So I only brought out those clothes which I thought that I needed to take a decision on. Rest of the clothes that I'm currently using were kept as it is organized. So for every category, if you feel there are things that you are currently using and you don't need to discard, you don't need to bring it up into a pile and then check each and every object, because it just adds to stress. Third one is, keep your bags ready, because as you are decluttering, you would want to discard certain things. There would be certain things that you would want to donate or you want to gift somebody. So it will be good to have bags in place in which you can keep these items, because it makes the process easier. You just have to lift these bags and keep it aside, and you know that each one is for a separate purpose. So keep your bags ready. Fourth one is, do your research. I usually gave my old clothes to the NGO Goonj or to H&M, and I used to get a 15% discount for one item from H&M. So these were the 2 places that I used to give. But right now H&M is not open, and even Goonj, the collection centers are not taking. Only the head office and the main offices are taking. So for me, the main office is very far from my place, so I cannot go and give it to them. So I had to do a little bit of research in finding out various places where I can donate the old clothes that I have. I will put these NGO lists in the description box below, so that if it is available in your area, you can use them. So doing your little research before you discard your items definitely will help you, especially with electronics. When you get into electronics, you would want to discard them, but you cannot throw them with your regular waste. You need to properly discard your electronics, because it's hazardous. So having done your research will definitely help you to know where you need to give those items. And the last one is, after decluttering, you need to take all these things out of your house. Because it's locked down, I'm sure you will find things a little difficult, but I'm going to do my research and I will also share with you the things that I get to know, where you can donate these items. And one interesting thing that I want to share with you is about the Buy Nothing project. which is a community which shares and gives items to others without getting anything in return, in the sense that I have my wedding gown with me, and if I want to share that or give it away to somebody, I can click a picture of it and put it in the community group, and if there is somebody who wants it can come and pick up the item, and that item is gone without any returns, that is without any exchange of another item or without any exchange of money. And this is not supposed to be sold. It's not a community where you're selling your items, but it's a community where you're sharing and you're giving away your items so that it can be used by another person. So I found it very interesting, but unfortunately in my area this community is not open yet. I will put the link of this community in the description box so that if you have it nearby, you can avail this opportunity and share the goods that are in good condition with people who need it the most. These are some things that I wanted to share with you. My next challenge is books, as I said, and for that we have planned a storage space which is yet not set up, but I will start doing the sorting because I would want to know which one I want to keep and which one I want to give away. So let's get started with books.